Tomorrow marks 1 year since the massive explosion ripped through BP's Deepwater Horizon drilling rig and killed 11 people, then triggered the worst offshore oil spill in the United States of America's history. The Gulf Coast and its residents are still trying to clean things up. We're told fish and shrimp trawling has picked up since the disaster, but many oystermen are reporting serious damage to once healthy beds. The Gulf's tourism industry took an enormous hit, with companies laying off workers and in some cases shutting down. Despite all of that, scientists say the overall health of the Gulf is nearly back to normal. But the experts are warning it's still way too early to determine to determine the long-term effects of the spill. Joining us now, Washington Post reporter Joel Achenbach. He covered the Gulf oil spill last summer. He's the author of A Hole at the Bottom of the Sea. In his preface, Joel says the story of the oil spill is, quote, as fascinating as it is horrible. And you may remember him taking a swim at one point. Joel, it's nice to see you again.
Shep, thanks for having me back on.
How are things there, I guess, in general?
Well, the Gulf environmental story is one that's going to be going on for a while as scientists try to figure out how much damage this event did. Keep in mind, you have marine communities that go down a mile or more. There's deep water coral. There are marine mammals that the mortality of which it's unclear. In my book, I try to make the point that this was not just an environmental crisis. It was a technological crisis, and it was sort of a management crisis for BP, for the oil industry, and for the government, because nothing like this had ever happened before. Think about it, Shep. A year ago, did you know what a blowout preventer was? I didn't know what a blowout preventer was. I could not have told you how big one was.
Joel, I didn't know what one was, but now I know enough about it to know that we're not sure that they work. What they've done is they've put in a number of new systems, a number of new rules about when you drill and what. But there have been no changes to the blowout preventer. And what we learned in this spill is the blowout preventer didn't work. So why all of a sudden are we granting new licenses in the Gulf of Mexico when the president said they had to get to the bottom of this first? I just don't get it. Is it politics?
Well, it's politics. It's money and the mix of money and politics. It's who has influence. We're an energy hungry nation. That's where the oil is. The industry wants to go back and drill in the deep water. The Obama administration has given 10 new permits for deep water projects that were already underway. I think the real question that people should ask is, has the industry done enough to make all these systems more robust? You mentioned the blowout preventer. What happened was the drill pipe, which was stuck in the blowout preventer, buckled. When the big blind shear rams came in, they didn't get a clean cut on it. So the question is, well, why would that not happen again? What have they done to improve the BOP? And the industry will give you answers like, well, you know, we learned so much from last year.
Yeah, that's not true, though. That's not the real answer.
Well, they certainly, this was a wake-up call for them. I mean, this cost BP probably $40 billion. That got BP's attention, and it got everyone's attention. I think the industry is in a different place today than it was a year ago today. That said, if you ask them, well, what are they capable of doing right now? They'll say, well, we've got these three ram capping stacks that we could put over a blowout if one were to happen again, which is what happened last year, except that you don't know that that's going to be the problem you face once again. They're ready to fight the last war. The question is, what's going to be the next technological crisis, if there is one, and let's hope there's not. But is it safe fundamentally to drill in these high pressure, high temperature, deep water wells?
And there are many who would suggest that the BP disaster answered that question for us. Of course, the industry would say otherwise. They need to come up with some ways. So Joel Achenbach, I look forward to reading the book. Thanks so much for your reporting here from the Wall Street Journal, the author of the book, A Hole in the Bottom of the Sea, available now at Amazon.com and everywhere. Fine books are sold. Washington Post. I said Wall Street Journal. I'm sorry.